On a scale from 1 to 10, would you say we were almost as good as the Rolling Stones?
Yes.
Would you?
Yeah, we're better than the Rolling Stones.
My favorite group for 30 years, to the High Hope.
Against people with disabilities. I think they should look at the person deep down inside. Each one has a special gift that they were given from God, and use that gift and go forward and try and give all you can give, you know.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, here he presents himself for Warsaw Concerto in the style of the great Mr. the Russian.
Said they told my mom to institutionalize me, that I was incapable of being in a family, you know.
What do you think, Paul? Is this a pretty good lunch or what?
Not bad considering his girlfriend was feeding him. 14 years of life together.
14 years, you guys. Wow.
Yep. Whenever I go to a dance, I don't dance with anyone. I dance by myself.
We don't want to go overboard, huh, Rich?
If
think he'd be going overboard if he did more than one kiss?
Probably, I don't know.
Do you want more than one kiss, Rich?
I don't know, that's it.
Well, I'm asking you. Don't you want more than one kiss? You do, right? Rich wants more than one kiss.
Daddy, I miss you. You are the one I can't look up to. Heaven's smiling at you. You are the one I can't look up to. Daddy, I miss you. Daddy, I love you. Daddy, I love you.
This is my name. Thomas is the last that Thomas is the that's my name I used to be, but now my name is Tom. That was you know, I used to be Thomas, Tommy. But now it's Tom Mountain.
You know, I proved the doctors wrong. I can walk, I can talk, I can sing, I can laugh, I can cry, and I can scream. Hallelujah! I don't want people to think I'm dumb and stupid or ignorant. Mm-hmm. Let's turn the tables around. How would you feel if you were in my shoes? You don't know. You don't know the pain and suffering that people like me go through with a disability. You don't have it, so why, you know, respect me for who and what I am. You know, I can't help it that I was born with a disability. I really can't. There's nothing I can do.
I got that coat.
Good, you have
diet coats,
why?
Yeah.
Hey, Gary. Gary, are you supposed to get this Diet Coke now?
Yeah.
No, you're supposed to wait until at the end of school. Is that right?
Right.
Right. And what time is that?
2:30,
right? So at 2:30 you can get the Diet Coke, right? Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'll take it and we'll put it in the refrigerator and you can get it at 2:30, okay?
Okay, I will.
All right. Okay. All right. Remember next time. And you did get a diet one, and that's good.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So you got one more hour to go. All right.
Right.
Okay. Just 1 hour. Right?
1 hour.
Okay.
Right.
Okay, Gary. So I'll put it in the refrigerator. You can get it with your ice and everything. Okay.
Okay. Sure.
Okay.
1 hour.
One. Hour.
Hour. All right?
All right.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
My daughter has a place to be because of the IELTS, because of Hope University. And I mean, I just, you know, Kevin and Dina, they get upset because they think I devote my life to Hope University. And maybe in a sense I do, but you know what? That's where I want to be.
Do you have money?
No.
You don't?
No.
What happened to your $20 I gave you for the tickets?
What tickets?
Remember at the fundraiser, I gave you $20 to buy opportunity prize tickets? Did you spend all that?
No, you gave me a...
I gave you a $20 bill. Do you still have change? It's okay to say yes.
Yes.
You still have money?
Yes, I do.
I know. I thought you would.
You work too hard, Mama.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I love to work. Hi, Stephen. This is Janice Reyes at Hope. And I was wondering if you have done the grant for the computers that I gave you a little newspaper clipping on the last time we had a meeting. Could you let me know? Because that has to be in by the 31st of March. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
He's a good bowler, man.
Oh, he is a good bowler.
Fresno.
Fresno. Number one.
Yep.
Yeah, he's going to get a trophy. Okay.
Done?
Have a good... You're done.
Go ahead. You can walk in or do whatever you usually do.
Okay. Bye-bye. I love you.
Raising money is probably the most difficult thing that we have. If we can get our own facility, we hope to have a capital campaign next year, and if we can get our own facility, I think we can be self-supporting. So second period money skills, you have 8. Wouldn't it be easier if you had less?
This group, it's a high functioning group, so they're
that's okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And I love being at Hope University. There's not one student that we have which I just do not cherish. They're the most non-judgmental population that I've ever worked with.
What am I going to do at this hour?
I don't know.
We're going to keep it kind of mellow because I have stuff to get ready and I have room to clean up and stuff today.
Oh, yeah, I want to know.
You just want to be in there.
Okay. Well, Kathy Acton, I entered a piece of hers in a show in Long Beach. It's Long Beach Arts, and it's not for people with disabilities. It's just mainstream artists.
Wow.
And she got in, and she got an honorable mention.
No.
And I entered a couple other pieces in an abstract show of Melanie's and Fernando's work, and they both got into that show as well.
That's
it's kind of snuck them in there, you know. Nobody knows, and, you know, the work. It's wonderful. So, we had an exhibit at what's the theater? IMAX theater.
IMAX theater. Where is that?
In Irvine.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
And it was a very nice exhibit, and Richard had a piece in that, a beautiful watercolor painting.
I know the bus number 9 the main platform, 3.
You know which bus to take? Great.
Yeah, I know where it's at.
Cool. Okay, let's
everybody
round it up. How about we go to class?
Our topic today is Russia. It's part of, they consider it part of Asia.
Yeah, well, I don't think so. Because they don't have the slanted eyes.
No, but they also consider like Saudi Arabia and India and Turkey and all of those places.
I consider Russia Europe.
Bingo. I don't do this.
I consider that European.
And
let's see.
I know Turkey's out too.
I have at least some words I know of. Privyet Kantala, which means hi, how are you?
Good. You're going to have to teach me some.
Oh, that's all I know.
Phrase dictionary. You could look at it if you want to later.
Not sure what math you
do. Hi, Paige. This is math.
Don't forget your dots.
Okay.
Can you use your dots?
Yes.
Okay.
Four.
Yes. Good. Two.
Yeah.
T.
No.
No.
Oh, ow.
W.
Yeah.
Yes.
Six.
Good, Kimmy.
Seven.
Here?
Good. Seven.
Yes. Good job, Frank.
I did it.
Correct. You did it.
Oh, yeah, no, we're just going to take the two keyboards and the drums. This is just the High Hopes, not the rest of the students at the school. This is strictly the High Hopes. I rehearse them twice a week, and then we do shows all over Southern California. And I don't know. Actually, they're probably going to go on a short tour about 2 weeks, probably the first 2 weeks of July. Northern California, Oregon, Washington. They've been all over the country. They played at the White House, at the Grand Ole Opry. They played all kinds of places. When you see the kind of barriers that they've broken through and the kind of obstacles they've had to overcome, it makes you look at your own life a whole lot differently. Things aren't so bad. Things aren't such a big deal, you know. They're very unique. Just like anybody else, I mean, they all have their own personalities. They all have their little quirks, and they all have their likes and dislikes. It's interesting getting to know them as individuals.
Cutie, elbow, and Petty.
Did you make it?
My mom did, at night.
Is that 9% fat-free and the cheese 90% fat-free? It's milk and cheese.
Probably should. Where's Paul's microphone? Kathy, check it off out here.
Right here. Stop yourself and say, I'm not nervous.
Okay. Don't look at
it. I'm not nervous.
Okay.
Everybody settle, we're ready to sit down. After a while, we have High Hopes Musical Group. This is a very talented musical group made up of persons with developmental disabilities. Their motto is train the talent and diminish the disability.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the skies. I think about it every night and day. I spread my wings out. I believe.
questions now?
You can ask.
Did you say thank you and shake your hand?
You can ask.
Thank you.
He said thank you. Oh, you're welcome.
How long have you been doing this?
Long off. Since she's been singing with the group since she was 14 years old.
How old are you right now?
How old are you?
You're
40.
Having fun,
I'm 40.
Aren't you?
You are. Raymond's the newest member. He actually guests with us.
He's funny.
Normally,
I
think he's cool. He's like funny. He's really funny. He has lots of energy. I like him. I liked him the best.
Me too.
Hello. You're cool.
Glutton, we bought kids.
High five.
Oh yeah, I'm born with a special disability called Rubenstein-Tavy syndrome. It's a special excitable disease where I get excited about anything and anybody. That's who I am as a special person.
They only thought my mom was pregnant at one, and then they found out towards the end of the pregnancy that she had two twins, and when they started to turn. And so Raymond was tucked inside where in his brother's chest, where his head was rubbing up against his brother's head, and his thumbs and his fingers were up against his brother's chest. So they both have red streaks running down the middle of it. Raymond started hitting the keyboard when he was like 8 months old, you know, and whistling, like things you hear on the radio. So, you know, my parents constantly kept that before the two twins, because both of them can play the piano and both of them are musically talented. Raymond tended to communicate through his music. And Raymond in his own right is, you know, a gifted musician genius.
This is his new piece. This is something, a new idea he's come up with. And I like the change. I like the way it's changing. So I'm saying, okay, Raymond, this is good. It has a good quality. This is the kind of thing that I like to see him do. I know he can do this kind of music. It's a sound that he hears and he feels in his heart. And then he needs someone to be able to encourage him to go to the next, what's the next step?
I J K L M N.
Count of three, we're gonna throw it up in the air. Okay, here we go. One, two, three.
And they fade in and then fade out. Like there'll be a shot of a hotel and it'll say, this is the hotel. Then it'll go away. See the brown hotel. I love them. I love these pieces. And I think that if they were in an art museum and someone didn't know about Darren, they would think, wow, how did they think to do that?
Remember not to put your fingers on it, Chris. See, look.
Why don't you tell her what you've been up to, Kathy?
Chris, look at your fingers, see?
All sorts of stuff.
See? it's got ink on it.
Charge.
You can use the stamp for it, okay? Oh, look. Look, Chris. Watch.
That's one thing that's a charge.
You want to try that?
Okay. So just let me know. Okay. Thanks, Sue. Bye-bye. Yeah. Thanks, Chris.
Chris's job at the interest.
He likes to do that every day. He really shouldn't do it every day, but he likes to do it every day, so we let him.
Mm-hmm. Well, now, was that someone calling to book High Hopes?
Yes, they actually have already booked them, but they want to change the date. They're scheduled right now for December 21st, but they think they're going to change it to the week before.
I'm sure it's a big answer, but how did you even get started with this?
A boy named Paul Keane came into my public school class for severely handicapped men with retarding. And blind boy, sat back in the back, didn't say a word. And if we played music, he rocked to the music. And one day I was saying, now what key did I play this in last week? Because I only got him once a week. And this voice from the back said, key of G, Mrs. Walker. I said, what? And that started the whole thing.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and for you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
With Paul, I don't expect too much, but at least with Paul, he can dress himself. That's a lot of, you know, help. He used to shave himself before, right, Paul?
Yes.
But now I don't let him because you can let him shave, but you have to be with him. Mm-hmm. You know, because, or else he will concentrate on one area and you will see that area is so red already.
Right.
So that's why I don't let him shave himself. After shower, he knows how to put his dirty clothes in the hamper. That's why his dirty clothes is on the back of his chair. He knows how to do that, and that's good enough. You're living with a family because they can still do things. They can help you. You can teach them what to do, how to do this. So at 8 o'clock, Paul, he goes to High Hope. And then he comes home at 4:30 to 5, around that time. Do you still play your keyboard?
Well, the keyboard's
real
just,
late at night. Real late at night. Oh, he goes to bed probably like, what time do you go to bed, Paul? 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock.
Kathy, how are you?
What's up, Kathy? We're here.
Paige and Robert's over there. Paige and Robert's over there. They're here. Yeah, there. They're over there. They're here. They're here. That's it. They want to see us in karaoke. Karaoke.
He has that beautiful voice and the sweetest person. I mean, you will never hear Paul say anything unkind about anyone. He's so appreciative for everything that's done for him.
I can't wait no more for you.
First thing we knew is that he had a heart condition. It was at San Diego at the Navy Hospital there. A doctor there says, well, you know, he's got a heart condition. And my husband looked at me because he had just come back from overseas. And I said, I didn't know that. No doctor had ever told us that he had been going to the doctor. And so we didn't know about his retardation until he was about two and a half. They feel that maybe at time of conception, maybe I was exposed to German measles. The doctor at UCLA sent us to a speech therapist, feeling he should be talking more than he was. And at that time, he was being treated for the heart. And so we went to this speech therapist, and one Saturday, just out of nowhere, she says to me, well, he does about as much as you can expect for a retarded child. And that was the first I knew. Nobody, about 2 and a half. Wow. Nobody had ever told me.
Our neighbor across the street had five kids. And
So she went, you know, there used to be like all little kids, they get into trouble. So the neighbor across the street would come and say, Richard, who did it? And Richard would always tell the truth. So somebody sometimes would get spanked because Richard would tell the truth.
I turned into a printer.
Uh-huh. Yeah, he turned people's sprinklers on down. The, he went up and down the street.
So he's been a part of the music group for how long?
He's right from the beginning, when it started off, and it's going to be 30 years, in January.
Special agents and people like that to get you going, get you motivated.
And money.
And
I'm probably maybe some people that brown nose enough to kiss someone's butt, probably.
I would personally need a bodyguard.
Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes I could see Paul and I as a duet.
I'd like to have a real relationship. You know?
It'd have to be someone who'd be very kind and loving and understanding. Mm-hmm. Not just someone who'd want you in the sack.
Mm-mm. Besides, I'm not that type of woman.
Oh? So what type of woman are you? No, you don't always have to have a boyfriend. Of course, it's nice when it comes to dance times and parties. You know, but it's not anything to be ashamed of. I find out when you just simply give up looking, lo and behold, they come into your life. That's how it was with Paul and I.
I can't see myself,
you know, living my life without him. So, I mean, he's like a special one for me.
I mean, I like to be married and have a husband. And,
when we all?
You know. Mm-hmm. I don't know. There's a lot to consider.
There's a lot to consider. PKU in plain simple English just means you have a lousy enzyme deficiency. That kind of makes it really hard for you to really travel and you eat differently from everyone else. Because you can't just eat any old thing.
Yeah. Kathy was a flaming redhead.
Still am.
4 years old. and she came in toe walking and wouldn't look at you. She had what we call gaze avoidance. Like today, she looks you right in the eye and lets you know what she thinks. At that time, she was nonverbal. Autism is a common problem in pediatrics, actually. I don't know how common it is, maybe one in 500 births or one in 1,000 or something like that. But a number of PKU patients had it in those days as a result of PKU itself. We put her on the diet and she really showed significant improvement. And within a few years she was talking and able to go to school and went through special education and graduated from high school and then went to Hope College or Hope University. And you've been there how many years?
It'll be 15 years as of this October.
Yeah, but I thought, it's a long time. But you've enjoyed it.
Yeah. Yes, I've enjoyed it.
I was even wondering when
mixture.
Maybe you might graduate and go to a regular community college.
There isn't a graduation program. This is an ongoing thing.
Ongoing. Well, have you thought of going to a community college? You've got the ability now.
I don't know. What if they know something more than I do? What if they're better at something than I am?
Well, there are people that are better at something than I am, too, you know.
Yeah, and then, of course, I'd pretty much miss my music now, wouldn't I?
Well, you have to think of your future, though, don't you?
Yes, but I'm also thinking realistically, too.
Yeah. Well, realistically, what are you thinking of your future?
I don't know. Maybe God has something to do with it. Maybe I'm basically to always sing.
Oh,
we know a lot of work has gone into this, and I'm most appreciative.
Well, you did a lot of the work, too.
Well, we worked a few years there. Now there's somebody else doing it. It's doing a great job.
Oh, how are you?
Oh, Jeff.
How sweet of you.
Oh, thanks.
We look forward to this.
Me too. Everybody yes. here has looked forward to
it. Good. Well, I hope they enjoy it.
Oh, I know they'll enjoy
yeah,
it.
Yeah, and the group's very excited to see you, and we told them that they cannot all rush around you.
Hey, I'm Mrs. Walker.
Gary, hello. How are you?
Pretty good.
That's good. Nice to see you. Tom, how's it
going?
Hi. Oh my goodness, you're full-fledged high hope.
Yeah.
And Mrs. Walker, here's Paul.
Paul.
Mrs. Walker, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Fine.
Fine.
Steve.
What's up, Raymond? Did you meet Doris?
A little shaky.
Okay. Why don't you have a seat? Relax, have some water.
Do you know what board is waiting on?
I know.
Hi,
sweetie.
Oh, that's well, the embryo ran down.
It's
so.
Been a long time.
Mrs. Walker, I lost weight.
Yes, you did. Well, Richie, hello there, man. How are you?
Fine.
Good.
Would you like me to take an introduction, Mrs. Walker?
Yeah.
You're the only one that has it.
So
okay,
good
baby.
To see you.
You want the money, baby? Money, baby?
Wasn't that wonderful?
Oh, boy, that.
Free art.
Come on,
you did.
Baby.
Doris, this is the newest member of our troop. Come on, Raymond.
It's okay, Raymond. Hi, Raymond. Nice to meet you. It's okay, Raymond.
Said he plays keyboard. He's been anxious to meet and he's doing great.
No more talk of dogs. Forget these white-eyed fears. I'm here, nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you beside you to guard you and to guide you. Are far behind you.
All I want is freedom, a world with no more night, and you always beside me to hold me and to hide me.
Then say you'll share with me one love, one lifetime. Let me lead you from your solitude. That's all I ask of you.
All I ask is one love, one lifetime. Say the word and I will follow you.
Share each day with me, each night, each morning.
Say you love me.
You know I do. That's all I ask of.
Raymond wrote this song.
Yes.
Wow.
He's
on keyboard. He's dedicated
to his freebie.
Paige, he's on keyboard.
Ready, guys?
Jim.
Here we go. One, two,
Raymond.
One,
Raymond.
Two, three, four.
Raymond.
Thank you.
High school in Anaheim, and Doris Walker was her music teacher. So I was part of the parent group that Doris consulted when she was thinking about starting Hope University. As the mother of a developmentally disabled child, I was thrilled to death to think that another step in our lives was going to be taken care of.
We were talking earlier, you know, I look now, Lori is a blessing. I'm very grateful that I have her. It was very difficult losing my husband, I consider it a young age, and to be alone, but I have Lori, you know, so it's great that I have, you know, Lori's so worried I'm going to find a boyfriend, and I said, Lori, don't worry about me finding a boyfriend, I don't have time.
Are you really worried about that, Lori? Mm-hmm. Really? Well, what do you think would happen if your mother found a boyfriend? You think that she wouldn't have the time for you?
Well, yeah, I'm...
You don't know if you feel comfortable around her?
And why? What do you tell everybody?
To me, my dad was the... best man for my mom. They did a DNA test, and it shows up in the blood work that she actually is Williams Syndrome. Most of them have to have open heart surgery, which Lori did when she was 3 years old, which causes the delays then. You know, the oxygen didn't go to the brain, and she didn't walk until she was about 3 and a half. Her ears are very sensitive to loud and screeching noises, but very outgoing. Another thing, they're musically talented. Most of them have musical talent.
Smoking. Hi, Paige. My name is Tom the Smoking Dude.
She's desperate for a relationship with a guy. And obviously, he was available.
Yes.
So there he is. He was the only one that was up for grabs.
I love Tom. He's a sweetheart.
Maybe, is there a possibility that maybe he had kind of like that charisma that your father once had that drew you to him?
I don't know. I think what drew me to Tom was he's very handsome and very sweet and innocent. And
yeah, it's not very worldly. That's a good way to get them.
I don't want any more phone calls from parents telling me my daughter is seducing their sons.
Have you gotten those phone calls?
Yes, I have. You know that. I don't want another phone call, so don't start that. Did I get a phone call?
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
Who'd you get a phone call from, guys?
Tom's father. You know that, Lori, right? Did I tell you that? Lori answered a question. Did I tell you?
No, you didn't.
Lori and Reyes? I told you that, and you know that.
I just said I like him. Why is that such an issue?
Well, it was with them. It isn't with me, but it was with them. Sometimes parents don't like their sons or daughters to have a relationship, what they consider a relationship. No matter how small it is. You don't have to have a boyfriend to be happy. You can find your own happiness. Right?
I guess, if you say. Treat me like a fool. Treat me mean and cruel. But love me. Bring your faithful heart.
Go, darling of yours, so lonely.
No, I used to.
Tom was adopted, and he was just 6 weeks old when we got him. Just a regular kid, you know, no different than anybody else. He's about 3 years old. We started looking into it, why he wasn't talking, and we went on from there, from family doctor to psychiatrist and speech therapist, what they have, what they call Fragile X syndrome, and that is, he has the symptoms of that. They have a problem of organizing all the information coming in, that comes into them. They're having a hard time organizing, and that's the way it is. Too much stuff goes on, Tom shuts it off. You know, he'll just walk away or just forget it. Don't bother me. Sometimes in school, too, when they have too many things going on, he'll just hyperactive, that sort of stuff. He's dyslexic, but he's very musical. That's for sure. Tom loves to sing. And he goes up to high hopes. I mean, he can't wait till his turn. He can't wait. I mean, the dead is that he's 100 inches past me. I mean, the fantasies of life. And though I wonder, and though I won't, I could be punker. I'm living home. The piece of legend in the face to make some honey just won't be. And picture hats and the fancy hands and any finer view. I'll bear the sandies of life will come to you. They'll come to you. They'll come to you. They'll come to you.
He doesn't like it.
Yep. What do you think about it? Anything?
Nothing to worry about, Richard. She's not taking me away from you.
I am not taking her out of me.
He's not taking me away from you, Red. She
nope.
Just has a crush on me.
Crush on her.
That's it. He just has a little crush on me. That's all.
But does it bother you that he has a crush on her?
No.
It shouldn't bother you, Rich.
What?
It shouldn't bother you.
No.
No. I don't know you. I don't know you. You are from Mars. All men are from Mars. Girls are from Venus.
Hi, baby.
Get away from me.
Hello.
Kiss. Keep your distance away from me, Freddy.
I think Frankie's in love with Mickey.
What?
I think Frank's in love with Mickey.
Hello.
Oh, brother.
This way, women.
Thank you, Rich.
Never mind.
I got this one. And this one.
Oh, let me see.
Well, that's my first album. The first one I did with 75. You want to hear it?
You can.
Mrs. Walker's on piano.
Mickey's been in the group, what, 20 years? Mm-hmm. 18, 20 years?
20 years, yeah.
Yeah. And she still marvels that she is in the High Hopes. Yeah. Mickey dearly loves it.
Yeah, she, you know, Mickey's 42, and I've been her stepfather for 38 years. And that's a long time. And she's been great.
Just knew, like when I was like 6 years old, 7 years old, I don't know if it's because my mom said something or I knew because, you know, they had told me. I don't remember Mickey. I remember Mickey like being really little, throwing a fit, you know, throwing like these little fits where she would be like, I'm not getting in the car, I'm not going. Being like, she would be like six, going, I'm not going, and just throwing tantrums like that. And I don't don't know if I knew that she was different then, or, you know, I can remember that. But you know, she went to the same school I went to until I was in eighth grade. She went to the same elementary school, same junior high school, and then she went to Hope School.
When sorrow blotted out my mind.
Mickey's favorite thing to do when she doesn't, when she's upset about something is, well, I'm not going then. Okay, I'm not going to school anymore. I'm not going. Yesterday, she wouldn't do something. She stayed home yesterday because she rubbed a blister on her foot. And I asked her to do something. She didn't want to do it. And I said, well, then we'll take you down to the bus stop and you can go to school. And she wasn't, I'm not wearing my shoes. She left with her purse barefooted. Of course, she was back in 2 minutes.
Turned around, yeah.
2 minutes.
She's got a mind of her own, isn't she?
She has a mind of her own, absolutely.
But overall, Mickey's
a joy.
She's
a great, great kid. She really is.
She's very loving and she's very family oriented.
You were there. And so whatever may come to me can never take you away from me. For in
my dad. That's his third wife.
And where's he at?
He's gonna be moving to Long Beach right now.
Okay. And how often do you see him?
I call him occasionally on the phone. My real dad was involved until we were like until 11 or 12, and then Mickey still talks to him on the phone. I don't. Mickey's the one that keeps him, you know, involved with my dad. She won't let me go. You know, Mickey's the one that picks up the phone and calls, you know, and she just stays involved with him. You know, I don't. I have this resentment. Mickey doesn't. You know, Mickey's just has no resentment, no whatever. She just calls, keeps in touch with him. He doesn't call or whatever. Mickey's like, hi, Daddy, how are you doing? You know what I mean? And you know, I love her for that, you know. I've called my dad before and said, you know, you don't know how lucky you are to have a daughter like Mickey, you know.
For in my heart you will always be there.
They decided it would be better that we went to a school that had all developmentally disabled, you know, students, you know. And Mickey thought she was going to Hope School to help the kids out. She went there to check out the school, and I remember her saying before she went to the school that she couldn't wait to go there and help out the students there. She didn't know she was actually going to school there. She couldn't wait to go there and help out the students. But you know, then once she started it, she loved it. You know.
Did I hear a knock at my door?
Hi.
My goodness, you're getting me right from the beginning. How are you?
Hi, hey, Robert.
Would you hope to find some relatives, do you think?
I think so, yeah.
You think maybe there's some relatives out there that might like to see you?
Sure.
His mom was I didn't know anything about him, and there was nothing in the records, and so I wrote to the state to find out what was about Gary and why, you know, all of his problems. And I got the birth certificate back, and his mom was an editor and publisher. And she did a lot with the Pittsburgh Press, and she had written several books, and she was the editor for
Writers and Dealers.
His father was a screenwriter in Hollywood. And I called everybody I could find by Ahern up in that area. I spent 2 years calling everybody, and nobody would claim anything, you know. The minute I saw him, I thought, he belongs with me, you know. he somehow, you know. And I knew that moment. I thought, well, he's part of our family from then on. Wasn't that right, Gary?
Yeah.
We both knew that you were. He looked at me as if, you know, I found you. And I looked at him and thought, I found him. You know.
That's beautiful.
And he calls me every morning to wake me up.
What time does he do that?
About 7 to 7:15.
Scotty, your best friend, Gary?
He sure is.
That's right.
Oh, that's terrific.
And I just sometimes I don't think I'm not going to get up today. And then that's it. Good morning, Scotty. He wakes me up, and I say, okay, I'll get up.
Where does Gary live?
He lives in Anaheim at a board and care.
This is the elder, so we're going down.
I was teaching independent living and basic education. Somebody came in and donated the church an old church organ, and the director put it behind my desk. And so the very first morning, he came in, rushed in, and he played. And I was absolutely astounded because I had no idea of his talent. So I said, Gary, you can play this. He said, yes. I said, you play piano too? He said, yes. I said, who taught you? He said, I listen and I remember. And I said, is that the only way you learn? He says, yes, I listen and I remember. And I thought, I have found something really priceless here. So I was determined he had to have some place where he could be heard. So I finally found this place in Anaheim. It was Doris Walker and the Nighthawks. And I got him out there. It was a long time, but we got out there, didn't we? And he's had a wonderful time there.
$100 extra, and that's considered P&I, and that's for him. So I ask his mother, do you know if he actually gets that amount of money, or do they control that also? So she said she thought he got it. We called Ron over and asked him, and he said they never give him anything. So she said, well, how do you go here, and how do you go there, and how do you pay for this, and how do you pay for that? And he goes, out of my money, I recycle my cans and bottles. And so she goes, you mean that they never give you money that they get for you? And he said no.
Okay, when I have the time, probably this week, okay, I will have to make an appointment.
Yeah.
I have to make an appointment for that. Okay, okay. No problem. Thank you.
playing the mandolin, and you're playing on the harp, banjo, and the guitar.
That's astonishing.
And the drums. You play drums.
The drum. I play bass too.
Bass too?
Astonishing. Who taught you how to play all those instruments, Ron?
Nobody.
Ron, what would you like for Bernice?
Excited I am tonight. 1 year ago we started planning this, and one of our biggest concerns was, would we get enough people to support us? And I'm telling you, I am overwhelmed. Everyone has been so generous. I would like to thank Doris Walker for allowing the High Hopes to happen as she describes it, and then going on to found Hope University. When you have a special needs child, you wish that life could be the same for them as your so-called normal children. However, you learn very early that it will be very different. I believe that Hope University is like a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. It is the answer to all of the questions we pondered as to where the trail would lead us in the future. Our adult special needs children have a place where they can remain as long as they feel they benefit. They are happy and look forward to each day in an environment which has been created just for them. When you hear them, you will never forget them, because no one ever does. And I want to thank you all personally for being here. It is wonderful. You're supporting a wonderful cause, and I really do appreciate it.
Thank you.
Richie Bros.
Coming this evening. The High Hopes have had an amazing 30 years, don't you think? Many faces have come, and many faces have changed. Some are the same, but there are some things that's never changing, and that is our dedication to love, music, the arts, and each other. We always get stronger as each year goes by. This is for you. It's considered our theme song. Take it away, Paul.
1, 2, 3, 4. To the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far. Fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm led to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable.